this story just happened last year. I work as a receptionist at a hotel, and we often hold high school proms here as we have a big hall and a stage. In order to get to the hall, you have to pass the reception desk. It was prom night, and it was already underway. All the students and teachers were in the dance hall. All the pictures had been taken, and the reception area was empty. At some point during the evening, someone approached the reception desk. I looked up to see a tall man standing there. He had a clean-shaven face, and his hair was greasy and tied back in a ponytail. He was also wearing a suit that was pretty old, and it was also dirty, along with some Adidas shoes. His eyes were wide open, and he said, "I'm here for the porn prom." At first, I thought he was kidding, but he looked dead serious. He accidentally said porn, then he said prom. I said, "Are you employed by the school?" He said, "No, I'm a student here." I still kept thinking he was joking. He looked to be in his late 40s, and he was telling me he was a high school student. So I asked him, "How old are you?" He said, "I'm 17. No, 16. Yeah, 16. At this point, I thought he was on drugs or something. I said, "I'm sorry, but you don't look 16 at all." He just stared at me, not saying a word, with his eyes wide, staring right at me. He then leaned over to me and said, "I'll make you a deal. I have a big blade in my pocket. If I'm not 16, you can cut my finger off. If I am 16, I can cut your finger off." I didn't get the chance to say anything because he walked out right after he said that. I told my boss about what happened. He said to let him know if he comes back and he'll deal with it. I finished my shift around 12, and I went to get in my car. There was an envelope under my windshield wiper. Written on it was, "A deal is a deal." I opened the envelope to see a human finger. And I had a feeling that this wasn't his own finger due to it being another color. I never saw that man again. And I always wondered why he was trying to get into that prom.
One day I was showering. My sister came into the bathroom and said, "Don't open the curtains." She said that her friend was going to use the bathroom because she couldn't hold it any longer. I said, "Okay." I knew someone was there because I heard noises. Then I heard the door close, so I came out of the bathroom. I asked my sister which one of her friends came. She answered, "No one came over. What are you talking about?" I got chills and I started to freak out. About 2 months later, I was sleeping in my parents' room with my mom and dad because I was scared to sleep alone in my own room. I woke up in the middle of the night. I sat down on the bed and then I saw something truly horrifying. I saw a lady in all white standing near the bedroom door, just watching me. I screamed and my parents woke up. They asked me what happened and I pointed at the lady that scared me. They asked me what I was talking about because there was no one there. I pointed toward its direction and said that there's a lady right there. My dad got up to turn on the lights. He walked right through the lady. As soon as he turned on the lights, the lady disappeared. We moved about 3 months later. When we were unpacking, I saw a picture of a lady. She looked familiar. When I remembered where I saw her, I got chills. It was the lady I saw when I woke up in the middle of the night. I asked my dad who was the lady in the picture. He told me she was my grandma. He also told me she died when he was 23 years old. My dad was now at the age of 41 when he told me. I got really scared after that. Now when I wake up in the middle of the night, I try my best to go straight back to sleep. It was April of 2007, and my birthday was approaching. Most of my family had already told me the gifts I would receive, like a new Wii along with video games for it. My grandmother didn't tell me anything. Now, my grandmother had always been a strange woman. She wasn't very talkative, but I liked to hear the stories she told. They were creepy, but intriguing. She told me she was going to give me a book. She didn't show it to me, nor did she tell me what it was about. Once my birthday rolled around, I was opening gifts from my loved ones. When I got to my grandmother's present, I opened it up and I saw a book with a pentagram carved into its front cover. I picked it up and thought nothing of it, because at the time, I didn't know what the shape was or what it meant. As soon as I grabbed it, though, everything went pitch black. When I woke up, my family was surrounding me, and my mom was scolding my grandmother about giving me the book. My grandmother looked at me, but her eyes were evil-looking. That night, when I went to bed, I was having a pretty good dream. But suddenly, something woke me up. I looked around and saw nothing. Then, suddenly, I saw a shadowy figure in the doorway looking at me. This wasn't a case of sleep paralysis because I was able to move, but that didn't comfort me because that meant it was real life. The figure crept closer and closer to me. When I looked closer at the figure, I saw gray hair and crooked teeth. That's when I knew it was my grandmother. I screamed and ran past her, but she grabbed me and tossed me back. I noticed she had something in her hand, but I couldn't tell what it was. I saw one of my toys that I had gotten a few years ago, picked it up, and threw it at her.
Strike first.
You're gonna pay for this!
Strike hard.
We're done.
Who's next? No mercy.
It's over.
This ends here.
Cobra Kai, the Karate Kid saga continues.
She fell to the ground and I ran past her, telling my parents. My parents called the police and they got there and arrested her. The thing she had in her hand was a knife. And she was planning on killing me. To this day, I wonder what would have happened if that toy wasn't lying there.
People call me Yaya. This happened to me when I was a young girl, maybe 7 or 8. It was a Saturday afternoon and my mother and I were at a mall shopping. We went from store to store, mostly for me. I was a spoiled kid. We went into a coat store, and I was pretty bored, so I would constantly walk away from my mother to play and stuff, as I did in every other store. My mother would always call my name, and I'd go running to her. This time, I was playing in a round coat rack. My mother called my name, and I ran out. I ran right into this older man. Then he grabbed me. He grabbed me by my wrists and asked me why I was running. I told him because I have to get to my mom. He then told me he could take me to her, but I said no, and he let go. It was weird because I saw this man in almost every store he went to, but he never had any bags. After that store, I had to use the bathroom really bad, so I went while my mother went to the food court. I sat down to use it for maybe a minute when someone else came in. The person walked right up to my stall. At this point, I was just looking at the person's shoes. They were men's shoes. I was confused of why a man would be in here. Before I could look up, the man said,
"Hey, Yaya, everything okay in there? I'll come in if you want me to."
It was the man from the stores. I looked up, and I could see his eyes peeking through the crack of the door. He then started shaking the stall. I began to scream. I've never been so afraid in my life. Then two women walked into the bathroom and the man took off. These women took me to my mother and told the police. They found him due to the cameras. I don't know what his intentions were, but the police said he probably would have kidnapped me. Who knows? From that time on, I would never leave my parents' side while in public.
This happened 2 months ago in January of 2019. My parents went out to a party. They told me they wouldn't be back until at least 3 a.m. in the morning because the party was supposed to start at 8 p.m. and the party was going to be in New Jersey. We live in Connecticut, so it takes a while to get there and back. They told me to watch my 10-year-old brother and expected me to be responsible because I'm 15 years old. When they left, we watched movies all night while eating a bunch of popcorn. It was around 11:30, and we just finished watching Infinity War. I told my brother to brush his teeth and go to bed. I stayed up later than him to watch the movie Logan. The movie ended, and it was around 2 in the morning. I was getting ready for bed when my brother came down the stairs. I asked him what he was still doing up, and he said the boogeyman was in his closet and wanted to touch him. I looked at him in confusion. My brother isn't the type of kid to pull pranks or joke around. He wanted me to check it out. I said, fine, and started saying he probably just heard a house noise. He said he heard a noise coming from his closet, and when he checked inside, the boogeyman was there and said he wanted to touch him. We went inside his room. I turned on the light and we went to the closet door. I opened it, and what I saw made me seriously angry. There was a tall, scruffy-looking man with long, black, greasy hair. He looked as if he was in his mid-40s and was fairly built. I was pissed off when I saw this creep watching my 10-year-old brother sleep, and I figured out what my brother meant when he said the boogeyman wanted to touch him. I was so pissed off, I punched his throat. He dropped to the floor, gasping for air, but I stepped on his face as hard as I could at least 6 times. He was covered in blood and was having trouble breathing. I grabbed my brother and ran into the bathroom, locking the door and calling the cops. Then I called my parents. My parents freaked out. In about 10 minutes, the cops showed up and searched the bedroom. He wasn't in there. They searched the house. He wasn't anywhere to be found. I gave them a good description of his appearance, and an officer even stayed at our house until sunrise. A week later, I was informed that the same guy was caught and arrested for raping an 11-year-old boy and murdering his parents. It turns out he had raped multiple children before and even murdered some of them and their parents. He was 47 years old and received a death sentence. If my brother never came downstairs to tell me what happened, then I fear the worst could have happened to him. And I'm extremely thankful that didn't happen. We used to have a maid from Indonesia, and her name is Wati. Well, one night it was probably around 2 a.m., everyone was sleeping. Suddenly, my brother and I heard my maid weeping. She was crying softly. We thought she probably missed her family in Indonesia, so we just ignored her and went back to sleep. The next day, at the same time, around 2 a.m., she was weeping again. This went on and on for 3 months. And we told our parents about it, and everyone had the same thought. She probably missed her family back home. One night at 9 p.m., my brothers and I were chilling in the living room. My maid was in the kitchen washing dishes. My dad was fixing the kitchen light, and suddenly my dad saw a shadow running around in the storage room. My dad thought it was one of us playing around, so my dad called out to my brother, "Can you please get the light bulb from the drawer?" But no one answered. Then my dad shouted, "Hey, can someone help me out and get the light bulb for me?" Both of us ran towards my dad from the living room, which is on the opposite side of the storage room. My dad then got confused and asked us why we came from the living room. We got goosebumps and walked into the storage room. We switched the lights on and saw that there was no one there. However, we saw the maid shaking. She looked at us, then started weeping again. My dad asked, "Who was that and why are you weeping?" My maid then explained that it was her guardian from Indonesia. My dad asked her to call him out and he was going to call the police. But my maid stated that it was not a human, but a spirit that was summoned to protect her. After that, my dad brought us to a nearby hotel for the night and hired a spiritual hunter to chase the spirit away. Following that incident, we no longer heard the maid weeping, and she was sent back to Indonesia 3 days after the incident.
Hey, yeah, I just got that video right there. Thank you.